Hello and welcome, fellow Spartans, to episode number 5 of my Massilia campaign for Total War Rome 2. Apologies, it has been a while since I did upload an episode for this campaign. It is back now regularly on the channel, at least 2 episodes out a week for you to enjoy. Obviously, my Wrath of Sparta campaign has been taking precedence over all my Let's Plays at the moment, so that has been fantastic, but obviously I need to get back to all my other campaigns as well. So an important channel update video as well, which will be released after this one, probably, which will give you some important information about changes to my schedule and just some various updates as well on the channel. So yeah, if you can, do check it out. It is important. It's got some important information in the video. So yeah, it is probably worth your while to do check it out if you can at some point. So there you go, ladies and gentlemen. Let's carry on where we left off. Now, these two settlements of Genoa and Allia, we cannot move those armies out of there yet because the cultural differences are still causing me some problems. So the military presence is keeping the public order stable for the moment. So I need to essentially get some more income per turn into the treasury. Then we can get these increased to a second tier or second level buildings, and then that will obviously bring cultural differences down, public order up as well. I need to get probably a dignitary in to my ranks as well to start spreading my culture across the lands as well. So that's going to have to be something we look at. Now, I cannot at the moment get a dignitary because I haven't got the research done for it to be unlocked. So once we've finished researching what we're doing at the moment, which is, where is it? Oh yes, this one, tactical drills. Once we've done that, we will then research scholarship to then hire a dignitary. So hopefully in this episode as well, I can't guarantee, because at the moment it seems that we're going to have to stay on our lands at the moment and just rebuild and regroup before we move out. But if I can, I'm going to try and take Nemesos down and then rid ourselves of the Arverni threat in the north. A couple of people have mentioned about either allying myself with Rome or going to war with them. I'm not in a position, I don't think, yet to go to war with them, but if I can ally myself with them, that would be rather good. So we'll try and do that as well during this episode for you guys. So yeah, I mean, what I'm going to try and do as well, I mean, obviously I know the Arverni are not just at war with me, they're at war with these guys as well. Is it the Vivicici? How do you pronounce that? To the west, and they could sweep in and finish off the Arverni. So either me or them, take them out. I'm happy with that. It's you know, either way, I can feel rest assured then that the threat of them has been removed. And while we're on the diplomacy screen, I'm just going to go and see what we can do. We want to take down aggression. That was close. That's quite close, wasn't it? If I offer payment, would that help? Oh, 100 gold's done it. Lovely. Trade? Would that? No. Trade's too far. What about Rome with trade? We've got non-aggression as well. Very friendly with them. Because I believe they ended their non-aggression with me last time, but then they rekindled it with me. So I'm pleased with that. Moderate chance with trade. Give careful attention. Ooh, they're offering 430 gold to have military access. I hope that's not, you know, trying to make me feel at ease and actually they're going to be sweeping into my lands and then turn on me. I don't think they would do that, so we'll accept that. It gives me 430 gold. Now, oh no. I thought you'd have probably done that now you've got military access with me. You're 169 plus with me now in military, sorry, in diplomatic relations with me. Surely you'd want trade now. Come on, seriously? Offer payment of 200 gold for it? Okay, maybe another time.
Well met, friend.
Maybe another time.
Your words move me to anger.
But yeah, I hope that's not a false sense of security for me, that they're going to try and lure me in and then come into my land and then, boom, wipe me out. I don't think they also say they would do that, but you never know. You never know. I mean, what I also need to do as well is I'm going to try and take maybe my spy, if when she's done with the Arverni, to take herself, or southeast actually, to start discovering more of these Hellenic factions over here, because I know these will want trade with me. Open up the, you know, the eastern part of the map, become wider known with factions across the lands, and then get trade with them, because that will boost my economy massively. So that will probably happen as well, or that will start to happen in this episode. So, even though we've had that boost, we can't do anything else. Let's brush out against these guys. Right, push them away from our lands. Hopefully Rome can finish them off now. Put them back into the city. Even though we've had that cash boost, we can't do anything with it. So we may as well end the turn, guys. See what happens. As I say, this could be an episode of me just rebuilding and not much action going on. We'll find out, because we don't want to just go into any fights willy-nilly just because we want a battle. We want to make sure we're in a strong position and we're building and building and building. Because obviously with Massilia being a one region faction when it started off, hello Pigeon, you know, it's harder, a lot harder than these bigger other factions that start off with more regions. It's harder to get going with these guys. Subject gains notoriety. Annoyed populace. Oh my god, I don't want that. What are you doing to me, you subject? One of your magistrates is complaining about the deteriorating quality of wine in his province. He claims even barbarians would refuse to drink it. Introducing wine standards. Yes, I think we'll do that. We'll introduce wine standards. Make sure that is sorted out. Oh, looks like the Arverni have now... Strange, they've actually set themselves up in a fortified stance outside of the city. That's a strange thing to do, I should imagine. Rome, any more interest in trading with us? No. I'm not going to offer any money because we need that money for ourselves at the moment.
Friend, and let us talk.
I know that would probably be a big ask, but I just thought I'd ask. But we've gone to neutral. So we've gone to quite good relations with them, so... I know we're only producing olive oil, and they are importing that, but would they be interested in importing some more? No. We need to get more tradable goods as well before we start to even think about gaining these trade options, I think, because people don't want to trade at the moment. Okay, attack them again. Okay, that's them gone further down in the Mediterranean. Okay, right. Food is an option, but we're still plus 3, so that's fine. If we increase this, we get some more wealth, we get growth, public order. Yeah, that could be a option, actually. I know it's a big thing to take on, but... Or should I go for the increase in the temples? Maybe I'll go for an increase in the temples this time, and then next turn I'll go for the... the increase in the town settlement. Now, what could be the best one here? So, wealth from agriculture. We haven't got any agriculture in that area, so no point in doing that one. We want a mixture of public order and influence as well. So, okay, that's got maritime commerce, which obviously we'll get from the port, so that would increase that. Gives us food as well. See, that's good, but it doesn't give me anything from agriculture. I'm going to go for that one. Hopefully that should start to turn the tide with that settlement now then. Okay. I can't really leave that spy, or sorry, bring that spy south. I need that spy to stay there at the moment, just in case the Arverni do anything. Oh, hello. Oh my god, where's that come from? Oh, wow. That has just caught me completely off guard. Jesus Christ. Well, there's no way we're going to be able to fight and win that one, so we may as well auto-resolve it. I didn't know they had another army in the south. Jesus. That has just changed everything on its head now. Oh, God. That's completely caught me off guard. I thought they had sacked it then, but they haven't. They've actually taken the land. Oh my god, wow. What are the Visivici Yoda de Corps doing? I thought they'd be putting pressure on them as well at the same time, but it looks like they're not. So that is interesting. And that's obviously made it now we're losing income and food because our tax harvesting edict has been cancelled. No. Well, that's being positive at least. Okay, right then. That is... incredibly interesting. We're going to have to attack sooner than I thought because they are risking causing us major problems now. Major problems. Right, so if we take them out at Nemesis, that will distract them from the south. Hopefully the Visavici can try and sweep in if they can. These guys, these are at war with them as well.
A flapping tongue that speaks without wit.
Non-aggression. I'd rather you, I wish you'd try and put some, I mean, I've got no allies, so I can't set them to be war targets against the Ardiverni, but if they could try and sweep in and cause some damage, that would be rather helpful. Right, we'll use our spy now just to see if she can sabotage him a little bit. 29% chance, probably not going to be able to do it. Oh, she's been wounded as well. Oh no, this is going terrible. This is suddenly going really badly. Okay. We may have to hire some mercenaries, but we'll do that next turn as well. And then obviously once we've taken Nemesis, if we can, we'll have to sweep round and try and push them back at Talassa. Let's hope they don't push out and take me at Massilia unguarded. That would be rather bad.
You find me a willing and attentive audience for your speech. Your proposals have some merit.
Rather you be defensive allies with me, but you won't. Right, okay, another end turn. Oh my god. This is tense stuff, ladies and gentlemen. Very tense. Hey, oh no, hey up. They're thinking about it. Oh, it's their spy. Oh, they've been successful, haven't they? They've been successful. So, retreat. What the order resolve is saying, it's quite strongly in our favour. We'll fight this one, guys. We'll fight this one. If we win, obviously, it makes the taking of the city of Nemesis very easy indeed, I should hope. And it's a bridge battle, or river battle. So, if we hold the bridge, this could be interesting. I never fought a river battle. I have, but not for a while. So, we pin him down with our hoplites. Use the ballista to our advantage. Sweep around with the cav. We could have a chance here. We could have a chance, but we don't know where they're coming from. We don't know where they're coming from. So what we'll do is we'll set up our army close to the opening of the there. Start the battle and then see where they're coming from and judge it from there. Right, okay. Pause. Excuse me. So no doubt they're going to try and sweep in over here. So let's... don't think we're going to get there in time, are we? Okay. We'll set up here. We'll set up strong here. Put our Levy Freeman over on that sort of right-sided flank there. Ballista, position yourselves here. Cav, go right over here into the trees. Sweep over there. Galatian or Celtic swords. General there. And Celtic swords, as I say, over here. We'll see how this one plays out. Let's hope you don't take the bait and come over this way. Let's hope you all come this way instead. I think they are, actually. I mean, the other way I could go with the cav is to go over this bridge here and then sweep all the way around back to him this way. But I think if I did that, A, it would tempt him to try and funnel off that way. And B, it would tire out the horses more. So if we go this way, then hopefully we can just go and bang back in from out the tree line. Hopefully. So, oh, hang on, there's a unit that's broken off here. Levy Freeman. I don't know where they're going still. They could still be coming this way. I'm not too sure. See, now the order result was more in my favour now than the actual battle itself, which is a pain. Line up, ladies and gentlemen. Line up, please. And we'll get the Hobbitate into the phalanx wall. The whole strong there. General hasn't got any abilities at all at the moment, which is bad, actually. Oh, I think it's because, actually, this isn't the general. I think they've wounded my general by looks thing. I think that agent took him out. Because I don't oh, no, it is him. Well, I don't actually know. I don't know, actually. It could not. It might not be, actually. Who knows? Let's hope the blister can win the day here for me. Okay, push out further on the right, please, calf. Now, these are citizen calves, so we can try and use them sort of a smash-and-go sort of tactic, hopefully, with these guys. Come on, Bliss, again to position. We just need to start peppering them now, really. Come on, move. Right, let's put them to fast-forward while we're waiting here. Right, okay. Right, it's going for explosive rounds. Group 1, the Hoppitays enter the wall. Now we need you to line up a little bit tighter than that, please. So that's it, rearrange them. Now, I'm not going to attack you guys. You've started out to attack me from your city. You can come and take me on. Shame these citizen cav haven't got full strength, so their numbers sounds like it'd be a bit more useful. Right, the blister assigned to fire. Come on, go. Target the Oathsworn. Target them. Go. These are terrible shots so far, isn't that great? This wall's a little bit wayward. Freeman! Right, we're firing now. We've got some hits there. What have they got? Have they got any? They haven't. Oh, they have. It's really on the left-hand side there, skirmishers. So we need to bring the cav in now to manoeuvre around. Come on, go, cav. Now the skirmishers have got two units of skirmishers, and they've got Gallic Light Horse. No, they're not great. We don't want to be intercepting with them, so we won't be fighting with them, really. Some good shots from the Ballista, though, taking down those Oathsworn rather well. Excuse me. Okay, guys. Move in. Okay, push against those skirmishers. Take them out. Watch, done. Firm. Levies. Come on. Move in. Oh, my God. Getting pinned down by the bloody foliage. Get in there. Right, break off. Oh, God. I hate cavalry. I bloody hate cavalry on this game. Do me head in. Got moved in quicker. They would have been messing around it so long. Okay, go into the back now. Come on. Levy Freeman always trying to break already. Let's move in the Hoppitays to move in. The general's got to commit now. He's got to commit to back up these Freemen. Got these swords to go around.
Our general is under attack.
It's okay. I'm going to pull the cavalry out, but I think the committee knows nothing I can do there. They've committed to themselves. Go. Well, they have only broken in the centre there. That's good. They're trying to push my left flank out. Cavalry, pull out. If you can, try and go for the skirmishers. Oh, they're wavering now, unfortunately. Hold yourselves together. Go for those light horse. So not the light horse, go for the skirmishers. Slingers. Fire. Levy Freeman. Well, we've got them beaten on the right flank, so we can start to move these forces around over this way a bit. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Take the general out. Come on, take him down. Just keep holding that Hoplite wall and you'll be alright. Oh, God. If this is a hit our own men, then that's not what we want. Oh, no, they've run out of ammunition. They've run out of ammunition as well, so it's all down to the lines now. Right, these guys have broken off, so push around the back here. Pushing against those Levy Freeman, thank you. Right, once these are broken, we can bring these around here. Come on, waver and go. We need to support these guys that are wavering now. Come on, well, come on, come on, come on. Break, 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 break. Come on. They keep waving, then they keep gaining the momentum again. For God's sake, guys, come on. Break them. Take them out of formation attack, see if that will make it any better. Right, these guys need to break off. Go and hit these Celtic youths because they are starting to cause me rather few problems. Well, they're committing themselves now, so we may as well go for a charge in the rear with these guys now. This is tough. This is very tough, guys. As long as the Hoplites hole, we're okay. So it's the Freemen that are worrying me at the moment. Right, wavering again. And is wavering in the centre as well. If they break, it's good. If they don't break, we're in trouble. Right, they're broken. Wonderful. Go over here then. They're wavering. Go for the Oathsworn General now. Go, 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 go. Right, starting to turn our way a little bit, I think, now, which is wonderful. Christ, if enabled to... Headhunt, yeah. That's not good. Right, take him down. Surround him. Right, slingers. Don't go for the general. Go for these guys. Push out against those Cadet warriors. I know we haven't got the best melee attack with our Hoplites, but we need to try and pin him down. Stop him from moving in. Well, this gives us a bit more time to try and take the general out. And we'll just obviously use our slingers to pepper these guys down. The enemy general is dead. Oh, wonderful. That's could be the turning point now. Great stuff. Yes. Wavering again from those units coming into the battle. Surround him. Come on, bring him down. Bring the bodyguard down. Hoplites have obviously done a fantastic job today. They've held their own. But we're not over yet. But the general is dying to go. That could start to panic the army now. And I think it has. Don't flee now. Hold. Come on. Bring these guys back. It's been a hard battle, guys. It's been a very hard battle. Right, they're shaking now. They should break in a second. And they're going for one last charge by the looks of things. Position yourselves, brace yourselves, ready, come on. Might bring these around the side. Oh no, these guys are still going actually, so we'll charge them from this way. Forgot about these two on the left. God, these Hoplites have done a fantastic job of holding these two units off. This shows how Levy Freeman are not in the same league of speed units as Hoplites are. I mean, these have won the day for me on this one. And, you know, it's a bit of a vain thing for me today. We've won the battle. Yeah, okay, we've won it. It's all good in that aspect. But it's all... It's all a worrying thing at the same time. Because, you know, we've obviously got that massive army that's taken to Lhasa. If no one of my... Sorry, none of their other enemies... take them on, then we could be in serious trouble there. So this is all a bit of a double-edged sword, this battle is today, I think. Okay, well, they are causing wavering now. Great stuff. Right, keep charging them down, though. Continue. Continue. See if we can chase any of them down before they get away. I think they're starting to make a bit of a gap now. No, we don't think we can catch them up. No, we can. We've still got a little bit of them there. No, let's give it up now. It's quit the battle. Obviously, it's a costly victory. It is indeed. But we've won. But at what price have we won? That is the thing. So, you know, again, comments down below, guys. What's my next move? What should I do? How should I handle this? Because, as I say, this Arverni army in the south at Talassa, I've completely caught me off guard. So, we'll kill the captives. They are going to be able to retreat back. This has opened my chance now to try and take Nemesis, though. Because I don't think I can get any agreement in terms of allies, so, you know, where do I go? Deserted. Oh my god, your inability to sustain your troops has caused desertions, leaving your army severely weakened. Oh, wonderful. That's just great, isn't it, Dad? Wings of Pegasus. The Wings of Pegasus. Right, okay. I'm going to go for... I was going to go for some Hepaeus Lancers, but I'm thinking of using one of Champlu's units here. Yeah, they're pretty good. Noble Spearmen. Yeah, we'll go for some infantry units. Another event. Another notoriety event. Okay, can we take in Nemesis? Oh, no. That's completely out of the question. Encircle it for a second. Let's just have a think about things here. Now Talassa is completely fogged over. We can't see what the hell's going on now over there. Genoa is suffering from some public order problems because of obviously probably the weather is causing that. Yes, yeah, so once the winter's passed, we can then maybe bring this army across to Massilia with the attempt to hold it there. Okay, there's several things here. So obviously this requires attention. The seas have be calm for quite some time. If we're to trade and send warships against our enemies, we may must regain the flavour of Poseidon by making an offering. Not sacrifice a child. Jesus, I'm not sacrificing a child. I sacrifice a bull. Good God. What people are these? So there you go, that's that. Research, we're going to go for the education one still, or the scholarship, because we want to get the dignitaries in to keep peace there. I have got some income at the moment. Maybe we could hire some mercenaries to help with this attack here. Because I think we do need to probably go for Cav, actually. So... there you go, ladies and gentlemen. I'm gonna wrap up part 5 here, and I'm gonna attack the city of Nemesis next episode, guys, as our first opening scene to part 6, basically. Hopefully the Ballista again, if they don't sally out, will have a chance of taking the city. I think the Ballista will turn it in terms of their destruction that they can cause, especially with being an open city and not walled. But as I said, comments below, tell me what I should do with this, where I should go with this, how I should handle this, because this is getting pretty difficult all of a sudden. So thank you for watching anyway, part 5. Remember to comment, rate and subscribe, drop a like on the video if you have enjoyed this episode and of course the return of this campaign. But until next time, this is Warrior Spotter for now, saying farewell!